What happens if I react a terminal alkyne with a strong base followed by an alkyl halide? We get a chain elongation, and in this Layer for Psi video, you'll learn the reaction mechanism and shortcut for alkylation using a terminal alkyne. The alkyne is more acidic than an alkene, which is more acidic than an alkane. This has to do with the increased S character of the sp carbon atom in the alkyne. Does that mean I can use a strong base like OH- to deprotonate the alkyne? Nope. OH- is not strong enough, so equilibrium favors the reactants. Instead, I have to use a really strong base like sodium amide. This will turn my acetylene into a deprotonated acetylide anion. Yes, know these names. You'll see this written as NaNH2 in NH3, not to be confused with Na in NH3, used for dissolving metal reduction to get a transalkene. Ready? Here's our alkyne reacting with NaNH2, which you should recognize as Na plus positive spectator and NH2 minus. NH2 will reach out for and grab that acidic proton, collapsing the bond between carbon and hydrogen back onto the sp carbon. This gives me the acetylide anion, an ideal nucleophile for SN2 reactions, along with NH3 in solution. Which brings me to step two, which is a chain elongation SN2 reaction. The acetylide will use its lone electron pair to attack the partially positive carbon atom, breaking the bond between carbon and the halogen. For a final product with a now neutral alkyne and a new bond to the purple carbon. And look at that. We started with two carbon atoms, and we ended with three for an ideal chain elongation. Let's see it again. Terminal alkyne reacting with NaNH2. Get rid of the positive spectator, so we have an NH2 minus that reaches for the terminal hydrogen, breaking the electrons back onto the alkyne. I flip the product so the electrons are to the right, making it easier to draw the SN2 reaction, where the negative electrons reach for the partially positive carbon and kick out the bromine. For a final product as follows. I have my four original carbons, a new bond, and my incoming alkyl chain, which I also flipped around. When in doubt, number your atoms to make sure you follow. We have four carbons in our starting alkyne. That's 1, 2, 3, 4. A new bond forming between the alkyne and what we'll label 5, 6, 7 with a methyl group on 6. If you're only asked for the product, don't waste your time drawing a mechanism. Instead, apply this shortcut. Step one, I know NH2 will deprotonate at this position, and so I redraw the starting molecule with a new bond at the terminal alkyne. My incoming nucleophile will attach at the leaving group position. That's this carbon, 1 and 2, and so we attach them, 1, 2. For even more on alkynes, including videos and cheat sheet, visit my website, layerforsci.com/alkyne, link below. Again, that's layerforsci.com/alkyne.